Item number, SCP-4821. Object class, Keter. Special containment procedures. Foundation personnel are to track down any civilians who have reported seeing an entity matching the description of SCP-4821. Civilians and instances of SCP-4821-1 will be interviewed and amnesticized. Instances of SCP-4821-1 who are minors are to be returned to their legal guardians. Description: SCP-4821 is a presumably extra-universal humanoid entity capable of several reality-altering effects. SCP-4821 stands 10 meters tall and proportionally resembles an androgynous, prepubescent human child wearing tattered clothing. In addition, SCP-4821's face is entirely smooth and featureless, with the exception of two large circular lights which act as its eyes. SCP-4821's body and clothing visually appear to be made of several miniature galaxies, but their actual composition is unknown. On its left ring finger is what appears to be a non-anomalous leather bag which contains several blankets, ice packs, and a single stuffed cow plush. To date, all known SCP-4821 manifestations occur when one or more human beings between the ages of 8 and 21 attempt to flee from their adult caretakers with no intent to return, hereinafter designated instances of SCP-4821-1. All instances of SCP-4821-1 have so far suffered some form of physical or emotional abuse from their adult caretakers. SCP-4821 will ignore any non-hostiles that attempt to interfere or interact with it after its manifestation, save for any instances of SCP-4821-1. Anyone who attempts an action it deems hostile towards SCP-4821 or any SCP-4821-1 instances will be rendered unconscious upon approach and will only awaken after SCP-4821 demanifests. Any machinery used with hostile intent toward SCP-4821 or SCP-4821-1 instances will malfunction until its demanifestation. Upon manifestation, SCP-4821 will begin to speak in an unidentified language to the instance or instances of SCP-4821-1 while gesturing with its hands and offering items from its bag. Instances of SCP-4821-1 who are recovered after an encounter with SCP-4821 claim that they did not know what SCP-4821 was saying, but could interpret from context clues such as hand motions or crude drawings traced in the ground. Should the instance or instances of SCP-4821-1 remain in the presence of SCP-4821 until it finishes gesturing and speaking, SCP-4821 will lay its right hand palm up on the ground. Should an instance of SCP-4821-1 climb onto SCP-4821's hand, SCP-4821 will express satisfaction and joy before demanifesting with the instance or instances. Should an instance of SCP-4821-1 leave SCP-4821, SCP-4821 will demanifest without it. Instances of SCP-4821-1 who choose to go with SCP-4821 will appear in a different habitable location within 24 hours of demanifestation, often a city or town, though occasionally aboard a ship or on an aircraft. Instances of SCP-4821-1 will not have any memory of where they were for the last 24 hours, but do remember their encounter with SCP-4821. Should instances of SCP-4821-1 take too long to decide between going with SCP-4821 or staying, SCP-4821 will begin to act erratically, showing signs of distress. After approximately 10 minutes, two large arms composed of similar material as SCP-4821 will appear behind SCP-4821, pulling it backwards into the air and demanifesting with it. Addendum. On September 28th, the Ethics Committee made a formal request to alter the containment procedures to anonymously report guardians of SCP-4821-1 instances to Child Services, rather than returning the instances to their legal guardians after amnesticization. In addition, they requested that attempts to physically contain SCP-4821 itself should be halted as all previous attempts have resulted in failure. The Ethics Committee argued this alteration would reduce resource drain on the Foundation and manifestations of SCP-4821 in the future. The request is currently being processed.